Our region is defined by fresh water. Vancouver Island receives some of the highest rates of precipitation in Canada, and because of that, we're surrounded by lush forests, tall waterfalls, rushing rivers, wetlands, and estuaries. Freshwater shapes our landscapes, and from spring rain to winter snow, it influences our daily lives. And yet, in our region and around the globe, freshwater faces challenges.
Climate change is caused by human activity, predominantly the emission of greenhouse gases such as carbon dioxide, which trap heat in the atmosphere, causing warming. On Vancouver Island, climate change is evident in weather station records that date back to the middle of the 20th century. The annual daily temperature is increasing, with nighttime temperatures increasing at a faster rate than daytime temperatures. When it comes to annual precipitation, rain and snow, the annual amount is increasing slightly, with rain increasing and snow decreasing. Seasonal variations in precipitation are becoming more pronounced, greater in the winter and less in the summer. This is causing stress to our water supplies, as more is available in winter, but maximum human use is in summer. Extreme events such as droughts and floods are becoming increasingly common.
A changing climate threatens the ability of watershed ecosystems to effectively collect, filter, and store snow and rainwater. Global climate models project an increase of the average annual temperature of nearly 3 degrees Celsius in our region by the 2050s. While this may seem small, this change in temperature means hotter and longer summers with an increased risk of drought, warmer winters with a decrease in snow accumulation, earlier snow melts in the springtime, and more intense storm and rainfall events, resulting in an increased risk of flooding. Warmer stream and lake temperatures pose a threat to fish and the wildlife that depend on them. Warming temperatures can also create more water demand for local landscapes. But through water smart landscaping, we can be efficient with our outdoor water use and be drought resilient. Though the future seems uncertain, we do know that our water use habits matter, and healthy, intact watershed ecosystems can mitigate the effects of climate change.
Wetlands are important watershed features that provide key ecological services and help mitigate the effects of climate change. Wetlands act as natural sponges, absorbing and then slowly releasing water to recharge aquifers and keep streams flowing, easing the impacts of drought. On the other hand, by absorbing and slowing flood waters, wetlands help prevent damage during heavy rainstorms while simultaneously protecting downstream water quality by trapping the pollutants that appear in surface water runoff. Wetlands also act as carbon sinks, helping to mitigate global warming trends. And on top of all this, by providing habitat for fish and wildlife, wetlands are crucial natural assets for supporting biodiversity, maintaining the water balance, and having resilient ecosystems.
Our everyday activities can have a huge impact on water quality and stream health if we're not thinking about how what we do on the land affects the water. What goes on upstream affects what goes on downstream. What happens on the surface can impact water below. Complex cross-jurisdictional boundaries further complicate effective water management. Land use and development has the potential to encroach on natural habitat and riparian areas and compromise the natural function of watershed soils and vegetation to slow and store water and protect water quality. However, partnerships across sectors, governments, and communities can bridge the gaps in effective water management and ensure through our policies and practices, we prioritize the shared stewardship of local watersheds. By understanding how a watershed works, we recognize how water connects everything across the land. We understand that storing and slowing water is important, that conservation and sharing is key. By considering watersheds in the way we develop land, interact with nature, garden, and use water in our daily lives, we can protect and restore healthy watershed function for generations to come, because every drop counts. Learn more about drinking water and watershed protection by visiting dwwp.ca.